It's time for the Family Feud. Introducing the Arzuman family. Bobby, Mary, Steve, Mary, and Cadence. Playing against our returning champions, the Blain family. Coral, Donna, Amber, Julie, and Margie. You're about to see these two families battle it out for $20,000 in cash. Cause it's time to play the Family Feud. Now here's the star of our show, Richard Karn.
Guys, it took a while. Look at you.
Welcome to the Family Feud, our returning champs, the Blain family. And they'll be playing against the Arzuman family. Are we ready? Coral, Bobby, come on. All right. We surveyed 100 people, top five answers on the board. Give me the most popular answer. Name something that's hard to get off your shoes.
Coral. Gum.
Oh, they're back.
They're going to play.
Okay, they're going to play. Welcome back.
Thank you.
You guys, introduce me to your family.
Okay, this is my wonderful mom, Donna. Uh-huh. This is my very musically talented sister, Amber. My very hard, just engaged cousin, Julie. And my very hospitable Aunt Margie.
Oh, and $22,000. What are you going to do with that?
Well, after Uncle Sam takes a little bit, yeah. We're going to put it towards a car, hopefully next year, for my husband. So.
Hi. Donna.
Richard.
How are you?
Good.
Well, name something hard to get off your shoes.
Dog poop.
Yeah, you know. Especially when it's fresh.
Yeah.
Dog poop!
Yes.
Now, you must have had an exciting night last night.
We had a baby boy.
You had a baby boy. And you're back.
Exactly.
For that college education.
That's right.
Well, $22,000 so far.
That's right.
Name something that's hard to get off your shoes.
Dirt or mud. It's dried up.
Good answer.
Mud. Georgia red mud. Mud. All right.
Hi.
Just engaged.
Just engaged.
So you had an exciting night last night.
I did. We won the money, and look at that. Hey.
Babies, engagements. You got to stick, you know, you got to be right on top of stuff here. Name something hard to get off your shoes.
Tar.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah. Tar. Right. Down.
Oh, yeah. Hi. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I don't have anything to follow with that.
You don't?
No. Nothing.
Didn't do anything exciting
babies,
last night?
No engagement.
What are you going to do with that $22,000?
You know, I have a special needs granddaughter, and some of the money is going to her to go to ability camp.
Good. All right.
Yeah.
Very giving family.
Yes.
Name something hard to get off your shoes?
I'm going to say grass stains. Oh,
good answer. Good answer.
That's right. Okay, if it's up there, you guys have swept the board. Yeah, getting them off those white bucks. Playing croquet, you got the grass stains. Grass stains! All right, that's only one. Coral. Something hard to get off your shoes.
I'm just going to say food. Is
food?
That too general? Is that okay?
Food? Okay. It's up there. You swept the board. Food! Huddling! The Arzumans are huddling, Donna.
Hard to get off your shoes?
Yeah.
That's the question? It's hard to get off your shoes?
That's been the question.
Oh, okay.
Now, let me check. Yeah, something that's hard to get off your shoes.
Paint.
Paint. There you go. Paint. If it's up there, you've swept the board. If not, the Arzumans get a chance to steal. Show me paint. All right, Donna, Mary. Shake hands. Good one. Came back from the brink. Top six answers on the board. Give me the most popular answer. Who do you think had the greatest mind in all of history?
Einstein.
Mr.
Einstein.
Einstein. Robert, you gonna play?
They're gonna play.
Okay, they're gonna play. Bobby, how are you, sir?
I'm fine.
Yeah?
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, well, introduce me to your family.
It's my beautiful wife, Mary.
Uh-huh.
It's my brother, Stephen. This is my sister-in-law, Mary, and my daughter, Cadence.
All right. What do you do?
I'm a detective with 25 years on the Los Angeles Police Department.
Wow. Wow, you protect and serve. We protect and survey.
That's right.
Steve.
Howdy.
What do you do?
I'm a dock worker in the greater Los Angeles Long Beach Harbor.
The greater. That would make you a longshoreman.
Yes, sir.
Now, where did they get that name from?
No, I don't know.
That answer.
Well, you know, send your cards and letters to him.
Yeah.
Okay, who do you think had the greatest mind in all of history?
I would think Plato.
Oh, good.
Yeah. You know, kids all over the world are still working with his product. Plato! Mary.
Hi.
Greatest mind in all of history.
Freud.
Oh, good answer.
Sigmund Freud. Oh, no. Huddle.
Come on, Cadence.
Cadence. Do you think great minds, do you think they all thought alike?
Sure, yes. Let's hope not.
Greatest mind in all of history.
Benjamin Franklin.
There you go. Ben Franklin. That's right. One of the few non-presidents to make our money. Bobby.
I'm going to say Napoleon.
Napoleon. Okay, great strategic. If it's up there, you're still alive. If not, the Blain family gets a chance to steal Napoleon. Okay. Carl.
Yes, very confident here. We are going to say Bill Gates.
Yeah.
Good answer.
Bill Gates.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. And if he didn't, he at least built the greatest brain, right?
That's right.
Microsoft, pretty smart. Okay, if it's up there, you've stolen the points. If not, the Arzumans get that money, 76 points. Bill Gates. The greatest minds that we can't think of them. Number three.
Leonardo.
He had that whole thing. He had the submarine, didn't he? Number four.
Gandhi.
Number five.
Jesus Christ.
That's right. I read his book. Number six. The score at the end of round one, the Blain family, 95. The Arzumans, 76. We'll be back with round two right after this. Don't go away. Welcome back to the Family Feud. The Blain family, 95. The Arzumans, 76. Amber, Steve. Wow, for a new mom, you look great.
Thank you.
Top five answers on the board. Name an animal you'd recognize just from a picture of its nose. Amber.
Giraffe.
A giraffe. Steve.
Elephant.
Yes. Elephant. Pair of black.
We're going to play.
Okay, they're going to play. All right, Mary.
Yes.
An animal you'd recognize just from a picture of its nose.
Picture of its nose.
The schnozola.
Rhinoceros.
Good answer!
Yeah. Rhinoceros. Oh, you know, they have that cute little button nose. Rhinoceros! All right, Cadence.
A pig.
Good answer!
Oh, yeah. That little kind of snout pig. Animal you'd recognize just from their nose.
I'm going to say a dog.
A dog. All right. Okay, Mark.
An anteater.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I sniff them up. Anteater. Holy smokes. They're huddling over there, the Blains, Steve.
I would say a dolphin.
Oh, good answer.
A dolphin, yeah. Yeah, okay. You see those down at the longshore?
Down in the harbor.
Dolphins. All right, Carl.
Let's go.
I think we're going to say horse.
Horse.
Good answer.
Very good. Okay, if it's up there, you get those points. Show me horse. I don't know. What's an unusual nose? What's number four?
Cat.
Well, it either had to be dog or cat, right? And number five?
Bird.
The Arzumans, 136. The Blains, 95. When we come back, we're going to triple the points to find out who's going to play fast money and a chance for $20,000. Come on back. You know, birds have a beak. It's not really a nose. Welcome back. The Arzumans, 136. The Blains, 95. Julie, Mary.
Good luck.
Good luck. Who's ever in the lead at the end of this question goes on to play Fast Money and a chance for $20,000. However, you only get one strike. Make those answers count. Point values are tripled. Top three answers on the board. Name something you might ask the person behind you in a movie theater to stop doing. Julie.
Talking.
Yeah. Talking. Play or pass?
We're going to play.
Okay. They're going to play. All right, Margie. You finally got it back to you guys.
Yeah. I'm going to say kicking your seat.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, good answer.
I hate that. Kicking my seat. If it's up there, you're still alive. Kicking the seat. All right, Carl. It all comes down to you. As captain of your team,
I've got a couple.
Comes down to you.
I'm going to say eating so loudly.
Yes.
The pup. Smacking.
Okay. Loud masticating, okay? If it's up there, you guys have taken the points and the game. If not, the Arzumans get a chance to steal the game away from you. Loud eating. Bobby, you guys played well. Strong cadence. You're welcome. Who's playing? Come on! When we come back, these mother and daughters are going to play for $20,000! Welcome back to the feud. The Blain family won the game, and it's time to play Fast Money and a chance at $20,000. All right, your daughter Coral is off stage. Since you can't see or hear your answers, I'll ask you five questions in 20 seconds. Try to give me the most popular answer. If you can't think of something, say pass. We'll come back to it if there's time left. Now, if you and Coral together get 200 points, you win another
$20,000!
All right, are you ready?
I'm ready.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Besides syrup, name something that might be served with waffles.
Butter.
Name something an Eskimo might own.
Igloo.
Name a creature that's known for carrying diseases.
Cats.
Name something a cop probably does at least 10 times a day.
Give ticket.
Name a room in your house where you might find a candle.
The bathroom. Yeah! Bathroom. I did good!
Woo! You do not want to go in there. Okay. All right, besides syrup, name something that might be served with waffles. You said butter. Absolutely. Survey said 23. I actually like peanut butter on mine.
Me too.
Name something an Eskimo might own. You said an igloo. Think they still got igloos?
I don't know.
Sure they do. Plenty of ice up there. Survey said 22! Yeah! Good job. Name a creature that's known for carrying diseases. You said a cat. They carry diseases?
Yeah, they do. Cat fever.
Cat fever. I got cat fever, survey said.
Oh, they still do.
Okay. Name something a cop probably does at least 10 times a day. You said, give tickets. 10 times a day. Oh, my gosh.
Maybe.
Survey said, wow. Good job. 74 points. Name a room in your house where you might light a candle. You said, bathroom. Yes. Nice scented candle. Survey said, 31. 105. Clear the board. All right. Coral. Mom did a good job. She got you 105. You need 95. I'll ask you the same five questions. You can't duplicate the answers. If you do, you'll hear this sound. I'll say try again. Give me another answer. It's tougher, so we're going to give you 25 seconds.
Okay.
You ready?
Yes.
Remind everybody of Donna's answers. 25 seconds on the clock. Time will start after I read the first question. Besides syrup, name something that might be served with waffles.
Peanut butter.
Name something an Eskimo might own.
An igloo. Path.
Name a creature that's known for carrying diseases.
Rats.
Name something a cop probably does at least 10 times a day.
Write the ticket.
Try again.
Drinks coffee.
Name a room in your house where you might light a candle.
The bedroom.
Yeah. Name something an Eskimo might own.
The coat. The fray coat. What's that called?
We got it. We got the coat. That's
okay.
Good.
Good job.
Okay. Wow. 95 points. No, don't be shaking your head. I think you gave some good answers. Now, besides syrup, name something you might... You might serve with waffles, you said.
That's what I used.
Peanut butter. Did you hear us out here? I put peanut butter on my waffles. Survey said. And we're alone. We're alone in that.
Jam, probably.
No, butter was the number one answer. I don't know what number two was. Name something an Eskimo might own. You said. A coat. That's right. Put on your coat before you go out in that igloo. Survey said. 23! That's better. That's good. Name a creature that's known for carrying diseases. You said, rats.
First thing that came to
me. Cats and rats. Well, cats didn't get anything. Rats are just smaller. Yeah. Survey said, I didn't mean that, though, for all you cat lovers out there. Mosquitoes, number one answer. Mosquitoes. Name something a cop probably does at least 10 times a day. You said, drink coffee, which means he probably goes to the bathroom at least 10 times a day. Survey said, six. Give tickets. Tickets, number one answer. You need 46 points. Name a room in your house where you might light a candle. You said, bedroom. How romantic.
Yes, it is. It'd be more if there was money there, too.
It'd be more romantic if there was 46 points up there, wouldn't it? Funny how a candle's romantic in the bathroom, but in the bathroom...
Not so romantic. Just
not as romantic. Survey said... Oh, number one answer, too. That was the number one answer. A five-day total of $23,040. They're not coming back. We'll see two new families next time right here on the Family Feud.